HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate, eliminate your pest problem. WPC family owned. Call them at 508-366-1820 or find them online at WPCPest.com. As we are set for the second inning, a 3-0 lead for the Hillers. A 3-run homer by Kayla Sullivan. And that gives Juliet Hume some room to work with. Due up for Needham are the 4, 5, and 6 hitters. Julia Ritzy, Lucy Colarusso, and Regina Longley. Hume deals. Just low. 2 strikeouts in the first inning for Juliet Hume. We'll get you some pitching stats in just a moment. There's a strike, 1-1. Juliet Hume has just had a remarkable season, pitcher of the year. A .19 ERA, 12-0 in 12 appearances, 11 complete games, 6 shutouts, 124 strikeouts leading up to this game. There's a strike there, 1-2. Has only given up 5 runs, only 2 of them earned. And that's after facing 267 batters. This is hit in the air, foul out of play, 1-2 remains the count. 72 innings pitched for Hume. She's just done a remarkable job for the Hillers. As Ritzy awaits the pitch, and there is strike 3. 1 away. We'll bring up Lucy Colarusso. Hume set to deal. Strike 1. The umpire just telling the bench players for Needham to stay inside the cage. Hume set to deal. On the inner corner for a strike. 0-2. To this set. Hit in the air, foul territory, out of play, a nice catch by a young fan. 0-2. Hume set to deal. Strike 3. She is throwing heat today. Regina Longley will come up to the plate. 4 strikeouts for Hume. To the set. There's a strike. 0-1. Hume deals, fouled away, 0-2. Hume set to deliver, fouled away. Hume to the set, fouled away. Good at bat for Longley. Hume delivers, fouled away. Gina Longley, a senior, a captain as well, and she'll take strike 3. 3 strikeouts in the second inning for Hume, 5 overall. We head to the bottom of the second, 3-0 Hillers. Welcome to Hopkinton High School as we are set for playoff softball. The Hopkinton Hillers welcome in Needham for their first playoff game of the postseason. And Needham had a pretty good season. They are towards the bottom of the bracket. They're the 16th seed at 11-9. But they got a big win against New Bedford as they had a play in the preliminary round. A big 3-2 win on the road in upset fashion. And today they are set to take on the Hopkinton Hillers as the captains meet behind home plate. And we are just moments away from getting this game underway here at Hopkinton High School as we take a look at the Needham lineup. And leading off for Needham is going to be Julia May, and she will play second base. Alexa Hurwitz will bat second and play right field. Allie Duggan will bat third and play third base. Julia Ritzy will bat cleanup and play center field. Lucy Colarusso will catch and bat fifth. Regina Longley will bat sixth and play left field. Shannon Kershey will bat seventh and play first base. Emily Rizzo will bat eighth and pitch. Annie Rotman will play short and bat ninth. And that Needham is led by head coach Stephanie Magny, assisted by Kate Condon, and also Trish Cruikshank are the three coaches for Needham. Taking a look at the Hopkinton Hillers defense, we'll start off with the infield. Lizzie Kelly behind the plate. Jenna Bogan over at first. Lindsay Whittles, the second baseman. Kate Welzel at short. Nikki Como at third. Juliet Hume will be the pitcher from left to right. It's Kayla Sullivan, Hannah Engstrom, and Renee Cooprider. Bob Hamilton on camera. Tom Nappy on the call. It is a gorgeous afternoon here at Hopkinton High School. A little bit of clouds in the sky, but the rain not expected to hit. There were some ominous-looking clouds before the game, but they have since disappeared, and the sun is shining. Both these teams seem like they are good to go, as the temperature right now, according to our HCAM Weather Center, is 70 degrees with a little bit of clouds, a 10% chance of precipitation. A factor that could affect today's game is the wind. There will be some wind gusts up to 12 miles an hour. Winds typically are going to range around 9 miles an hour, but it is typically windy here, and every single softball game we've done, there has been a good amount of wind, so I don't think the Hopkinton Hillers are too worried about that. Let's take a look at the full bracket as we have all the first round decided, as the preliminary round games have taken place. Of course, Hopkinton, the number one seed in the South Division I bracket, as they earned the bye in the preliminary round and got the pass right to the first round. And if they win today's game, they'll also get another home game before the rounds where you play at the neutral site locations. So not a bad deal for the Hopkinton Hillers. And we'll take a look at that full first round right now. And of course, today's game, Hopkinton and Needham, is at the top of the bracket on the left side for the first round. And then the other games have already taken place. Hopkinton getting a bit of a late start due to prom and some other school-related activities in both Hopkinton and Needham. So they're playing a little bit later than everybody else. Marshfield played Notre Dame Academy in the first round. Notre Dame Academy got the 6-3 win in 11 innings. The winner of this game will play Notre Dame Academy. And Notre Dame Academy is the 8th seed in the bracket, excuse me, the 9th seed in the bracket. They are 13-3, a very good team over at Notre Dame Academy. And then rounding out the bracket on the left side, Taunton and Weymouth. They're actually playing today as well. They played already, they played last night. And the winner of that game ended up being Taunton. And then Bridgewater, Raynham, and Whitman-Hanson round out the left side. And then on the right side, Milford Advanced. They'll take on Silver Lake. That game's also this afternoon. And Norwood will take on King Philip. As we are set for batter number one. And stepping to the plate for Needham is Julia May, the second baseman. It's playoff softball on HCAM, and we are set to go with game number one for the Hillers. And the first pitch is a strike, 0-1 of the second baseman, Julia May. Hume is set to deal to the set, to the lefty, and there is strike two. Hume awaits the sign and deals. Strike three, one away. Alexa Hurwitz will come to the plate. And the Hillers are well rested for this game. They have not played since last Thursday. So they've had almost a little over a week off as there's a strike. In fact, a little bit more than a week off for the Hillers. Hume delivers down low. Sometimes it's interesting to see how that amount of time off affects a team. Can they get back to the white hot pace they were playing out before? As there's a bunt, little blooper, and Hume will make the catch. Two away. But so far, it is early, but Hume does not seem to be affected by the time off. And she certainly threw a lot of innings in the later season, so I'm sure she was more than happy to get a little over a week off as Allie Duggan, the third baseman, steps into the batter's box and takes strike one. Oh, and one. Hume to the set. Strike two, swinging strike. Hume awaits the sign and deals. Strike three, a three-pitch strikeout. Two strikeouts in the inning. We head to the bottom of the first. It's a scoreless game between Needham and Hopkinton. Bottom of the first inning, the Hillers coming up to the plate for their first time today. Let's take a look at the Hopkinton Hillers lineup. Hannah Engstrom will bat first and play center field. Lindsay Whittles, the designated player, batting second. Lizzie Kelly, the catcher, batting third. Kayla Sullivan hitting cleanup, playing left field. Kate Welzel batting fifth, playing short. Jenna Bogan batting sixth, playing first. Juliet Hume batting seventh and pitching. Nikki Como is batting eighth and playing third base. As a bunt laid down by Engstrom, and she beats it out. Lucy Colarusso came up from behind the plate, but had no throw down the line, and Engstrom is aboard to start things off for the Hillers. Rounding out the batting order is Molly Bennett playing second base. And Renee Cooprider is the odd man out of the lineup. Emily Rizzo on the mound for Needham. Infield playing in on the corners as there's a strike. Let's take a look at the full Needham field. We'll do that in just a moment after Emily Rizzo delivers this pitch. Emily Rizzo, a senior captain for Needham, as this is on the ground, up the middle, the flip to second, and they get the lead runner. So Whittles reaches on the fielder's choice, and there's one away for Lizzie Kelly. The field for Needham, Shannon Kershey over at first, Julia May at second, Annie Rotman at shortstop, Allie Duggan at third base, Lucy Colarusso, the catcher, is that pitch up high. From left to right, Regina Longley, Julia Ritzy, and Alexa Hurwitz for Needham. As Rizzo is set to deal, and is down low. The Needham Rockets with the infielders in on the corners. Pitch delivered for a strike. Lizzie Kelly has been a fantastic hitter all season long, and this is on the ground. Third base side, picked up at short, throw to second, not in time, and everybody's safe. A single for Lizzie Kelly as Lindsay Whittles advances to second. One away, two on. And that'll bring up the cleanup hitter, Kayla Sullivan. As Rizzo is set to deal. And this is a pop fly, foul territory, and out of play. 0-1. Rizzo to the set, and that's fouled away, 0-2. Kayla Sullivan, a 5-16 hitter, played in all 20 games during the regular season. Scored 27 runs, drove in 33, five home runs, as Kayla Sullivan led the TVL in home runs among many other categories. Rizzo set to deal, and this is hit in the air towards the left field fence, and that is gone! A three-run homer, Kayla Sullivan! Speaking of home runs, clearing the bases, 3-0 Hillers. And I'll bring up Kate Welzel. Welzel, a junior, a 368 hitter on the season, has a home run of her own. Has driven in 22, or actually driven in 21, scored 22 as there's strike one. I'd say left field is the deepest part of this ballpark. So some serious power displayed by Kayla Sullivan as there's strike two on Welzel. Rizzo deals up high. To the set, swinging strike, and there's out number two. Jenna Bogan will come up to the plate, the first baseman. A 464 hitter on the season, played in 19 games, and she fouls that one away. She scored 12, driven in 20, has two home runs on the season. Also has legged out six doubles. Bogan does have a lot of power as Rizzo deals. And that's fouled away, 0-2. Rizzo to the set. Infielders in on the corners. That's up high, 1-2. Rizzo set to deal. Upstairs, 2-2. Rizzo to the set, and this is hit into left center. That drops down for a base hit. It'll roll back towards the fence. Bogan is going to slide into second safely. A double for Jenna Bogan. And there's that power. As Juliet Hume will come up to the plate, and Hume has been a force to be reckoned with the bat as of late, has hit in 14 games, a 304 average on the season. Has scored seven runs, driven in six. As there's strike one, 0-1. Rizzo to the set. Swinging strike, 0-2. Rizzo deals, and there's strike three. Well, that will do it for the inning, but not before. Kayla Sullivan goes yard past the left field fence. It's 3-0 Hillers heading to the second inning. Bottom of the second inning, Hillers up 3-0 on the Needham Rockets. In the first round of the playoffs for the Hillers, Nikki Como, Molly Bennett, Hannah Engstrom do up, the 8-9-1 hitter. Pitch down low, 1-0. A huge crowd here for the first postseason game for the Hillers. A lot of Needham fans made the trip as well. This is hit in the air and foul at a play. 1-1. Nicky Comos had a nice season at the plate, a .298 batting average in 18 games. Has scored 9 runs, driven in 12, also has a home run to her credit. Rizzo deals. Hit in the air towards right center, and that'll drop in for a base hit. She's going to round first. The throw to second is not going to be in time as it pulls Julia May off the bag, and it is a double for Como. That was actually Annie Rotman, the shortstop covering, and that'll bring up Renee Cooprider. Excuse me, not Molly Bennett. So Renee Cooprider coming to the plate. A last-minute change for the Hillers. She pulls back the bunt. Infielders playing in on the corners. Cooprider, a .268 hitter. Has played in 15 games. Scored 14, driven in 5. And the bunt down the third baseline, foul. A 1-1 count. Infielder still in on the corner. Rizzo deals. Breaking pitch is just low, 2-1. To the set. And that is low, 3-1. Cooprider is a force to be reckoned with once she's on the base paths. Rizzo to the set, down low, and she draws the walk. That'll bring up Hannah Engstrom, who bunted her way onto first safely in the first inning. Cooprider always a threat to steal, 9-for-10 in stolen base attempts. The bunt once again up the middle. Throw to first is going to be in time. But Engstrom gets the job done. She pushes Como up to third, Cooprider up to second, so a sacrifice there. One away for Lindsay Whittles, who hit into a fielder's choice her last time up. As the lefty steps in. Whittles, a .448 hitter in 18 games this season. Here's strike one. She scored 19 runs, driven in 23, has 3 doubles, a triple, and a home run. Rizzo deals. Hit in the air, foul out of play, 0-2. Due up on deck is Lizzie Kelly. Rizzo to the set. Hit in the air towards the left side, and that is foul. Rizzo shakes off the first side. Set to deliver, and that's hit foul. Rizzo to the set, upstairs, 1-2. And it looks like they're calling the runner out at third for stepping off the bag. Perhaps she did not retouch the base after. This happened earlier. And actually, in the Holliston game, I believe it was, this happened. The runner, the Hillers runner, was not retouching the bag after every pitch. And they called her out. That's going to be two outs. Tough break. Rizzo deals. On the ground, up the middle, that gets through. Cooprider being waved around. The throw home is going to pull the catcher off. It's 4-0 Hillers. Throw to second, they got her. Whittles trying to take second on the throw in. Does get the RBI single, but thrown out. And it's 4-0 Hillers. We will head to the third inning in the first playoff game this season for the Hillers. Big crowd on hand here for Hillers postseason softball. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Cornerstone at Milford, a new senior community featuring apartment living with innovative programs, services, and transportation to help seniors stay independent. Conveniently located on Route 109 near 495. More at cornerstonemilford.com. As we are set for the third inning, a 4-0 lead for the Hopkinton Hillers. And due up for Needham is Shannon Kershey, Emily Rizzo, Annie Rotman, the 7th, 8th, 9th hitters. Is Juliet Hume, who has 5 strikeouts so far in this game, is set to go to work. Hume to the set. That's fouled away, 0-1. Hume set to deal. That's fouled away, 0-2. Shannon Kershey, a junior. Hume to the set. Fouled away, count remains 0-2. Hillers playoff baseball on HCAM. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. A 4-0 Hillers lead here in the top of the third. Hume set to deal. Hit in the air and above the reach of Kate Wellzell. It's a single. And the Needham faithful cheering loud as Kershey reaches with the first Needham hit of the day. That'll bring up Emily Rizzo, senior pitcher. Pinch runner coming in for Kershey. It's going to be Jody Quinter, sophomore. Out for the steal here with Huma on the mound. Needham's going to try to manufacture runs as much as possible. Hume deals, fouled away. To the set. Swinging strike, 0-2. Wide up and the pitch, there's strike three. as Kelly will pump fake towards first and get it back to Hume, one away. Annie Rotman coming to the plate. Hume to the set, the bunt laid down, foul. Wind starting to pick up as a little bit of cloud cover rolling in. Hume set to deliver to the sophomore. The bunt laid down, up the middle, Hume picks it up, throw to first, two away. Kershey pushed up to second. That'll bring up Julia May. Julia May was a strikeout victim in the first inning. She's a sophomore. Versatile player. Pitcher, fielder, second baseman. Today playing second base as the lefty awaits the pitch. Swinging strike, 0-1. Pinch runner Jody Quinter on second base after a single by Shannon Kershey to lead off this inning. Hume to the set, down low, 1-1. Hume to the set, swinging strike, 1-2. Set to deal. Strike three. That is the seventh strikeout of the game for Juliet Hume, and we will roll on to the bottom of the third, 4-0 Hillers. Bottom of the third inning due up for the Hillers, the third, fourth, and fifth hitters, Lizzie Kelly, Kayla Sullivan, Kate Welzel to face Emily Rizzo. As the senior captain set to deliver the first pitch for the Needham Rockets of the inning. There's strike one. Lizzie Kelly landed on first safely with a single, ended up scoring a run on the Kayla Sullivan three-run homer in the first. A 368 hitter through 18 games as she fouls this one away, 0-2. Another interesting note about Lizzie Kelly, a 431 on base percentage. Pretty impressive numbers from the seniors. That pitch outside, 1-2. Rizzo set to deal, there's strike three. We'll bring up Kayla Sullivan, who hit a three-run homer in the first inning, her sixth of the year. The outfielders are moving back towards the fence, playing very deep. That pitch up high. The question here is, will Rizzo test Sullivan? Will she give her anything over the plate? That pitch just inside, 2-0. Rizzo deals, that's outside. And I don't know if Rizzo's going to test her here. And she will not. Four pitch walk to Kayla Sullivan. That'll bring up Kate Welzel. Kate Welzel, a junior, 368 on the season. Has scored 22 runs, driven in 21. Seven doubles for Welzel. Tremendous multi-sport athlete. That's fouled away, 0-1. Rizzo to the set. Swinging strike, 0-2. Rozelle did strike out in the first. Rizzo to the set. Up high, that gets away, and Kayla Sullivan will advance to second on the wild pitch. Rizzo set to deliver, fouled away. Count remains 1-2. To the set, hit in the air, a sky high pop fly and handled by the shortstop, Annie Rotman. Two away. I'll bring up Jenna Bogan. Bogan hit a double her first time up. Down low. How about Kayla Sullivan, a .577 on base percentage. Fouled away. 1-1. Rizzo to the set, hit in the air, and it is out of play. 1-2. Rizzo set to deal, fouled away. Count remains 1-2. Rizzo set to deliver, on the ground, up the middle, through the legs of the shortstop, Sullivan, rounding third as the ball rolls into the outfield. It's 5-0 Hillers, throw to second. Is going to be cut off, and it's another double for Jenna Bogan. So the Hillers get another run as Juliet Hume comes to the plate. How about Jenna Bogan? A couple great hits in this game. Pitch to Hume, hit in the air, and foul. Another great catch by the same young fan that caught one earlier. I think the Hillers might have a new ball boy here. Rizzo set to deliver. Upstairs, 1-1. As the clouds looking more and more ominous. Rain not supposed to hit the area, but you never know in New England. That pitch down low got away from the catcher. Bogan is going to advance to third. I'm giving that a pass ball. Could go either way, but it looked like it was manageable, but Colarusso just could not get a hold of it. 2-1 on Hume. Rizzo deals. On the ground, a slow roller up the middle. Got by the glove to flip to first, and that is in time. Nice job by Julia May tracking it down, and that will retire the side for the Hillers, but not before another run is played as Jenna Bogan drives in Kayla Sullivan. It's 5-0 Hillers as we head to the fourth. Top half of the fourth inning, a 5-0 lead for the Hopkinton Hillers. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Fletcher Tilton, attorneys at law, serving central Massachusetts and beyond with responsive solutions, guided by three basic principles, integrity, leadership, and excellence. Fletcher Tilton, visit them online at FletcherTilton.com. Due up for the Needham Rockets is the second, third, and fourth hitter, Alexa Hurwitz, Sally Duggan, and Julia Ritchie, to face Juliet Hume, who has seven strikeouts in this game. Hume is set to deal. Upstairs. To the set, down low. Hume is set to deal. Upstairs. 3-0. Hume delivers, and that is a four-pitch walk to Hurwitz. So Alexa Hurwitz on base to start things off. Allie Duggan will come to the plate, and Lizzie Kelly going to have a discussion with Hume, calm her down a little bit. It's very rare to see Hume give up a four-pitch walk. A 5-0 Hillers lead here in the fourth. It's round one of the playoffs for the Hillers. They got the bye in the preliminary round. This is his first round action. South Division I bracket. Head coach of the Bellingham Blackhawks, Dennis Baker Sr., also here to support his son. Bellingham competing in the Division II playoffs as that one's bunted behind the backstop. And they'll actually play later tonight in Bellingham. Bellingham, the defending South Division II state champions, or the defending Division II state champions, excuse me, in softball and baseball. Quite a season last year in Blackhawk land. As Hume delivers, the bunt is laid down. She did not pull that up. That is a strike. It did get away from Kelly. And advancing to second is Hurwitz on the pass ball. Oh, and two count. Hume deals. There's strike three. Eight strikeouts in the game. Hume to deliver to Ritzy. This is hit in the air, a pop fly, and it is out of play. Oh, and one. Hume to the set. Strike two. Hume is set to deliver. This is hit in the air towards the fence, and that is caught by Hannah Engstrom. And that was a little bit scary there. Two away, runner still on second. Lucy Colarusso to the plate. Hume deals, upstairs, 1-0. Upstairs, 2-0. Hume set to deliver, fouled away. 2-1. 3. Mirabli keeping her arm loose in case Hume runs into any problems. Hume deals inside. 3-1. To the set. That's ball 4. Second walk of the inning for Hume. We'll bring up Regina Longley. Longley struck out her last time up in the second. Hume deals. There's strike 1. Hume to the set. Inside. 1-1. Hume awaits the sign. And deals. Fouled away. 1-2. Hume delivers, and this is batted in the air in foul territory. Wellzell chases it down and makes the catch. Nice job by Wellzell, and that is the third out of the inning. A couple reach for Needham, but they still remain scoreless. 5-0 heading into the bottom of the fourth. Bottom of the fourth inning, and due up for the Hillers is the 8-9-1 hitters, Nikki Como, Renee Cooprider, Hannah Engstrom to face Emily Rizzo as she delivers. There's strike 1, 0-1. Como reached on a walk and scored a run in the second inning on a Lindsey Whittles RBI. That's fouled away, 0-2. Rizzo set to deliver upstairs. 1-2. Rizzo to the set, swinging strike, 1 away. That'll bring up Renee Cooprider. She reached on a walk her last time up in the second. And scored the only run of the inning. Rizzo delivers down low. To the set. Down low, 2-0. Oh, excuse me, there's a strike, 1-1. Rizzo delivers, 2-1. Renee Cooprider, a 268 hitter heading into this game. That's down low, 3-1. He's only walked 3 times so far this season. On the ground, up the middle, gloved by the second baseman. Throw to first, not a problem. Nice play by Julia May. A 4-3 ground out for out number 2, and that'll bring up Hannah Engstrom. Rizzo delivers, infielders in on the corners. The bunt is laid down, rolls down the first baseline, and it was touched by the first baseman. And they're going to call a foul. I thought she touched it, but the home plate ump didn't see it. And Engstrom will go back to the batter's box. And she might have touched it in foul territory. That one's low, 1-1. Engstrom has walked 7 times this season. On the ground, third base side foul, 1-2. Rizzo delivers. Up the middle, gloved by the shortstop. Throw to first is perfect. A 1-2-3, bottom of the fourth. It is 5-0 Hillers. We head to the fifth inning. Top half of the fifth inning. It is a 5-0 lead for the Hopkinton Hillers in their first playoff game of the postseason. As due up for the Needham Rockets is the 7th, 8th, and 9th hitters. Shannon Kershey, the first baseman. Emily Rizzo, the pitcher. And Andy Rothman, the shortstop. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Angels Garden Center, located at 65 School Street, growing in Hopkinton since 1957. Visit them online at angelsgardencenter.com. Hume is set to deliver. Hit in the air and foul, 0-1. Kershey reached on a single in the third inning. To the set, that's up high. 1-1. There's strike two. 1-2. Very good turnout here at Hopkinton High School today for this playoff game. Hume deals. Strike three. Nine strikeouts for Hume as Emily Rizzo steps in. Hume deals. There's a strike. Como playing in on the right side. Rizzo is a bunt attempt. There's a bunt threat, rather. Hume delivers, fouled away, 0-2. To the set, strike three, strikeout number 10. Andy Rotman will come to the plate. Hume delivers, strike one. To the set, fouled away, 0-2. Hume set to deliver. Strikes out the side. 11 strikeouts in the game for Hume. We will head to the bottom of the fifth. 5-0 Hillers. Bottom of the fifth inning. The second, third, and fourth hitters due up for the Hillers. Lindsay Whittles, Lizzie Kelly, Kayla Sullivan to face Emily Rizzo. First pitch is down low, 1-0. Rizzo's pitched a pretty good game so far, especially when you take a look at this Hillers lineup, which is just stacked. Six players in the first all team, as this one will get by the reach of Julia May and into center field, a single for Whittles. She's having a pretty nice day today, 2-for-3 with an RBI. Now Lizzie Kelly will come up to the plate. She singled and scored a run in the first, struck out in the third. Infielders playing way in on the corners. They're just about banking on the bunt here as that pitch was outside, 1-0. To the set, and this is hit into center field. That drops in for a single. Whittles pushes up to second. Kelly is aboard. Kayla Sullivan to the plate. Rizzo set to deliver upstairs. For those of you just joining us, it's Hillers playoff softball on HCAM. Bob Hamilton on camera. Tom Nappy on the call. It's 5-0 in the bottom of the fifth. Hopkinton leading Needham. Rizzo to the set. Outside. 2-0. Julian Hume has pitched a great game. 11 strikeouts. Struck out the side in the top of the fifth. Rizzo delivers down low. A 3-0 count. Dangerous territory here for the senior. And she's just not going to give Kayla Sullivan anything to hit. She's going to load up the bases here. All right, maybe not. There's strike one, 3-1. She'll slip one in there. I'll be surprised if this is hittable. There's ball four. Bases loaded. Kayla Sullivan had a three-run homer in the first, which scored Lindsay Whittles and Lizzie Kelly. Then in the third, she walked and scored a run, and now she walks again. Bases loaded, no outs. Kate Welzel at the plate. Rizzo to the set. Hit in the air. A high fly ball, which is going to stay on the infield. And it got blown around a little bit, but a nice catch by Annie Rotman. All runners stay put. So one away, base is still loaded. Jenna Bogan at the plate. And she's having a terrific day. Two doubles so far in this game. An RBI double in the third. Scored Kayla Sullivan in the third. That was the fifth Hillers run. There's strike one, 0-1. Rizzo trying to work her way through a jam here. To the set. Hit in the air and foul out of play, 0-2. Juliet Hume due up on deck. Infielders playing in all over the infield dirt as that pitch is low, 1-2. Bogan is a threat to bunt. She has some very good speed around the base paths. Hit in the air, out of play. Count remains 1-2. To the set. On the ground, first base side, and it's in and out of the glove of the second baseman that threw the first baseman's legs, and everyone's safe, and a run scores. And that is an error. Whittles comes around to score. Kelly up to third, Sullivan to second. Juliet Hume to the plate. A 6-0 lead for the Hillers, and now an infield discussion on the mound. Or in the pitcher's circle, I should say. Hume 0-for-2 on the day. Infielders, as expected, playing in. Hume certainly a threat to bunt. Rizzo set to deliver. She'll swing and miss, strike one. Rizzo to the set. That is strike two. Two up on deck, Nikki Como. Bases loaded, one out. One run in for the Hillers on an error. And she'll crush this into left field, a liner. One run around to score. Kayla Sullivan being waved around. 8-0 Hillers. A two RBI single for Juliet Hume. Got a great piece of that ball. Bogan push up to second. A liner right into left field. And now Nikki Como at the plate. Swinging strike. Rizzo deals up high, 1-1.
Hey, what do you say, Marta?
There's strike two. Como, a 298 hitter this season through 18 games, has scored 9, driven in 12. Infielders in on the corners, up high. 2-2. Rizzo set to deliver. On the ground, up the middle, past the glove of the diving shortstop, Annie Rotman. Jenna Bogan being waved around. The throw in is not going to be in time. Gets by the catcher. Hugh moves up to third. An RBI single for Nikki Como. It's 9-0 Hillers. Renee Cooprider at the plate. 1-for-1 with a walk. Scored a run in the second. Upstairs. Miss Hiller's lineup, they're dangerous throughout. Fouled away. Rizzo set to deal. That broke a little bit too low. 2-1. Rizzo to the set. Hit in the air, foul. 2-2. Rizzo to the set. That's fouled away into the Hillers dugout area. Rizzo to the set, and that'll roll foul. Rizzo to deal. Hit in the air and foul. 2-2 remains the count. Still only one out in the inning. Four Hillers runs have been plated. That's fouled away. Good battle here between Renee Cooprider and Emily Rizzo. Rizzo to the set, fouled away. great battle. Rizzo to Deal upstairs. 3-2. And that one is high. Bases are loaded. Coming up to the plate, Hannah Engstrom. Bree Mirabli going to go warm up. It'll be interesting to see if they bring her in to maybe rest Hume. There's strike one as that's fouled away. The Hillers have batted around here in the fifth. With a 9-0 lead, you're pretty comfortable. Maybe you bring in Mirabli because the Hillers likely going to be playing on Monday, which will only give them a day off. At least that's my guesstimation. Because technically they're playing the first round later than everybody else. Everyone else has already played in the first round. Rizzo to the set, up high, gets by the catcher. Everyone's gonna stay put. 2-1. Rizzo set to deliver, up high. 3-1. Rizzo to the set. Inside, and Engstrom draws the walk. Juliet Hume comes around to score. 10-0 Hillers. Como up to third. Cooprider to second. Engstrom to first. And coming up to the plate, Lindsay Whittles. This game has officially been blown wide open by the Hillers. Rizzo delivers inside and called a strike, 0-1. Rizzo to the set. And this is hit in the air towards the fence, and that'll drop in for a base hit. One run around a score, two runs around a score, and it is a 12-0 lead for the Hillers. Whittles advances to second on the throw in, a two RBI hit. Engstrom to third. And that will do it. The Hillers have mercied Needham in the first round of the postseason, 12-0. They plate seven runs in the bottom of the fifth. And what an effort by the Hopkinton Hillers. The lineup really just came alive and was completely unstoppable. And there was nothing that Needham could do once the rally got going. The Hillers never looked back, and they take the game 12-0. We'll come back with some finishing thoughts in just a moment. Tom Nappy here as the Hopkinton Hillers defeat the Needham Rockets 12-0 in the first round of the playoffs. It looked like it had the potential for a pretty good pitching matchup between Emily Rizzo and Juliet Hume to start, but then the Hillers' bats came alive, and that plan kind of backfired for Needham. The Hillers' offense just never looked back. Let's take it right to the bottom of the first. Well, first, actually, in the top of the first, Hume struck out two, so there's something to take note of. But then in the bottom of the first, Hillers played at three runs, all coming from a three-run blast from Kayla Sullivan over the left field fence. In the second inning, another run for the Hillers as Renee Cooprider scored on a Lindsay Whittles single. That was after Hume struck out the side on the top half of the second. And then in the third, two more strikeouts for Hume. Bottom of the third, Hillers played another run. Kayla Sullivan scores on an RBI double by Jenna Bogan. And then in the fourth inning, it was actually a little shaky for Juliet Hume. She gave a pretty deep hit to center. It was a flyout by Ritzy and a couple walks, but got out of the inning unharmed. And the Hillers also went down 1-2-3 in the bottom of the fourth, the only inning that the Hillers did not score a run, but they would make up for that in the fifth after Juliet Hume struck out the side in the top of the fifth. The Hillers plated seven runs and were just absolutely unstoppable in the bottom of the fifth. Let's recap the inning. Lindsey Whittles led off with a single, Lizzie Kelly a single, Kayla Sullivan a walk. Kate Wells-Ale flew out. Bases loaded for Jenna Bogan. She reaches on an error, a run scores. Juliet Hume, a two RBI single for two more Hillers runs. Nikki Como, an RBI single. And then Renee Cooprider would walk, and that would score a run. Hannah Engstrom would walk, and that would score another run. Then a two RBI single for Lindsey Whittles, and that would be it for the game. The mercy rule went into effect. The final score, the Hillers 12 and Needham nothing. The Hopkinton Hillers score 12 runs on 12 hits. Needham scores no runs and has one hit. Juliet Hume got the win and the complete game. Five innings pitched for Hume. She also gave up only one hit and had 11 strikeouts in the victory. As for Emily Rizzo, the Needham starter, she went five innings, giving up 12 hits, 12 runs, 5 walks, and had 3 strikeouts. So the Hillers will advance to play Notre Dame Academy in the next round, and that will be the quarterfinals matchup for the Hopkinton Hillers as they advance to play another day. That will be a home game for the Hillers, and that will, regardless what happens, be their last home game of the season, as after that it is neutral site games. But the Hopkinton Hillers look good in the first round of the playoffs. Once again, the final score for the final time, the Hopkinton Hillers defeat Needham in the first round of the South Division I playoffs, 12-0. For Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for watching Hopkinton Hillers softball on HCAM Television.